Hey everyone, I wanted to do a quick video today to answer the question I get more than any question about the HydrosPlus Performance Kit. That is, how much does it increase your lifting capacity? And so, fortunately or unfortunately, the answer to that is zero. The HydrosPlus Performance Kit simply increases your fluid flow to your implement circuit. What that means is your loader will move faster. And you still have the variability with your stick, but you can go faster at lower RPMs or at higher RPMs. And this is my opinion. You can ask others who have it out on Green Tractor Shop. The two functions on the loader actually work easier. It's easier to find that sweet spot. That sweet spot is bigger when you have more flow. When it comes to the backhoe, everything moves more quickly. You can move four functions at once if you use the HydrosPlus, at least with the high capacity pump or the extreme capacity pump. Now, with the kit alone, you can definitely do two and three pretty easily. Four, you can do four, but you have to really work at it. I would not say that it would allow you to do four easily. The other two definitely will, especially with the highest volume pump. No problem at all. So that's what it does. It increases flow, does not increase lift capacity, and that's because it does not change the pressure at which your hydraulic system runs at. Now, the good thing is, if you don't want more flow, you don't want faster backhoe or faster loader, but you do want to lift a little bit more, you can increase your pressure without buying the kit. Now, what I'm going to do is show you how you can change your pressure, whether you decide to increase your pressure beyond what the factory spec is simply up to you. So the factory spec, I should have looked it up before I did this, I think is 1950 or right at 2000 PSI for the 1 series. I believe using the same loader, other tractors actually have a higher pressure spec. So that is what it is. What I'm going to do on mine is I'm going to check it first, and then I'm going to turn it up. Yeah, probably to, I'm going to get a little bit extra. I'm going to go 2100. And if you just to answer your question, for the HydrosPlus Performance Kit, everything that I've built is rated but for at least 3000 PSI working pressure. And working pressure means that's what it can run at a constant rate. Burst pressure typically is about four times that. So you're talking about, over 12,000 PSI or 12,000 PSI for burst pressure. So as far as the kit that I provide, it's rated up to that pressure. So let me take you in and show you the pressure relief valve. And this is for the loader, but it actually, I have to do a little bit of investigation to see if this pressure relief valve, and you can see it here, actually affects the pressure that you get to your backhoe, because any pressure relief valve in the system, once they hit their max pressure, they're going to drain the tank. So you really, think about a chain is only as strong as its weakest link. The pressure in your system is only going to be as high as your lowest set pressure relief valve. So you have a jam nut here, and you have a Allen wrench nut that you need to turn. So here, 14 millimeter goes on the jam nut, and then to increase pressure here, you will turn clockwise. Decrease pressure, you turn counterclockwise. Okay, so that's how that's gonna work. I'm actually gonna go ahead and break this loose, because I have a feeling I'm going to need to make a change. I'm putting it back to where it was, where I think it was. So, the second thing you're going to need
is a pressure gauge.
And that's here. It's glycerin filled, liquid filled, up to 5,000 PSI. Needs to have a hose. Well, it doesn't need to have a hose, but it needs to have some way to connect to the SCB on the front. That's a quarter inch coupler. You could connect it directly by screwing it on. Don't do that. I would say go to Ken's bolt-on hooks and buy his. I don't think you can put this together. If you can put it together for cheaper, it's going to be a few dollars cheaper. Not going to be worth your time. You're going to run around town trying to find the parts because, as you can see, I didn't know that he sold this when I built this a few years ago. I'm not sure how long he sold it, but you got to go from one quarter MPT, and then I've got two adapters here with this. It goes into this hose. Another adapter here to go to the O-ring boss. All of that together, my guess is, I paid like $16. Each one of the two fittings is, that's probably $10. So it's 26. The hose is probably $20, 30, 46. I think Ken's is $45 for the quarter quick connect. This fitting's probably five. This fitting here is probably 10. So I probably ended up spending $60 plus, if you don't include shipping. So it's a no-brainer to go and get that. Again, if you got a few parts laying around, you might be able to save a dollar or two, but it's probably not gonna be worth it. I'm gonna take this off. This is the boom circuit. This would be up, this would be down. Connect this in. Wonder Ken swivels. Mine doesn't swivel, so it's hard to actually. So I'll start her up. So it looks like I'm about 1800 PSI. Let's get in here. We'll do this in quarter turn increments. I've already broke this loose. I'm gonna give this a quarter turn. Let's see if I can do this both places. So that's it. Now that I've got that set, I set mine about 2100. Looks like about a quarter turn is going to give you about 100 PSI, just to give you a sense. If you do this for yourself go in and you want to go up by 100 PSI or 200 PSI, 200 PSI, you need to go up by that much, about a half a turn. You'll get it. So, and when you snug this lock nut back up, make sure that you keep this in one place so you don't change. So let's go ahead, just for good measure, start it back up. And I'm at 2000 RPMs. You really just need enough RPMs to build pressure. You don't have to go to wide open throttle. It might do a little bit more at wide open throttle, but it's not gonna be, but a few tens of PSIs most likely. So I set it at, it was about 2150 at 2000 RPMs. It eked up to about 2200 at wide open throttle, which is 3400 RPM. So I hope that's helpful. Obviously we're all adults here. Decide what you need, but I would say my recommendation is stay at factory spec, so that there are no concerns about how your tractor operates. But for, I know that some of you may decide differently. So that's how you would do it if you so choose. Thanks for watching.